that seems to be growing here. So already now we just have barely half an hour left, and I hope you have your questions lined up. So while I ask the person in the middle, okay, the person from Responsible Netism, Tushar Bhagat, he is from Ahan Foundation, and he's going to tell us a little bit about the kind of, you know, because I'm aware on and off of the kind of amazing stuff you guys have been doing in schools and with other agencies. So please line up with your questions while he describes very briefly to us what all they've been doing along the lines of cyber hygiene policy.
So basically, just to describe what we do in this area. So we generally go from school to school as of now. We teach them, we have a set guidelines or set presentations for 5th, 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th, 9th, 10th, and college students. And we teach them like how you can secure your account, what are the issues it can create when you don't secure your account, what are the policies or what is the rules by law which you can break when you actually post something which is not supposed to be on the internet. So we teach all these things. However, and I see there is after last session, I see it's creating a positive impact as of now. So definitely it's a kind of certificate for us. So that's good. Apart from that, we actually make sure that we don't make them afraid about the internet. So we show them some of the good things which students has already done with the help of internet, and now they are at some position, they started their own company and all these things. So making sure that they should not afraid, and second thing is they should make a positive impact out of it. I have seen we have a board out there, and I have seen somebody from our audience actually put one comment saying that don't teach our parents so much so that they will actually stop us for doing that.
Right. Zyada mat padha unko, thoda malum hai utna hi kafi.
That's right. So I personally don't know, like we are not actually into that. So we make sure that it creates a positive impact. Second thing, when we talk about cyber, it's not about the technology which is creating a problem. It's about the people who wants to use that technology on a wrong side.
Correct.
They are creating a problem. So we are just trying to help them to identify those people and don't do things which are they are asking you to do.
Correct.
Something like that. Third thing I would like to mention is in yesterday's conversation, somebody said like you can patch a software, but you can't patch a stupidity. That's rightly said. However, I have a second opinion on that. Being in a IT, I know this can be even patched. So we can have.
So he knows how to patch stupidity. When yeah, can right. I come to you, sir? I need a few patches.
I'll tell you an incident which happened in 2004. We were working on one US-based company, and we developed one software from them, which actually takes a credit card information, processes the entire thing, and it saves the credit card information just to make sure they don't have to enter same again. People used to save, choose that option and save this thing. What US government has is like somebody from Mexico hacked their entire database.
Okay.
They have all those credit cards. We did a complete encryption of this thing. They broke that encryption. What we did is like we just sweep the credit card information. So just a couple of digits got interchanged. So these guys have called these people directly who has actually ordered and asked them, what are your last four digits of your credit card? We just want to verify.
Okay.
This was the stupidity by that user. He should not give the credit card information on this thing, phone. Mm-hmm. What happened is a person from a telecom or a government, you can say, they jumped or barged into a call as a third person, and they said like don't give any information, this call is not from US, this call is from Mexico, and we are cutting it down. And don't do this again. So that kind of technology currently we don't have. So hopefully if we come up with this kind of solutions which help them to identify where is this call is coming from, this can be patched.
Correct.
So I believe in Responsible Netism or Ahan Foundation, we believe this thing has to be a four-way approach. First thing is the software, where you can have some softwares within your phone or within your PC,
device, whatever,
which will help you out. Hardware, which will allow you to secure the things on the internet where nobody should enter or hack your information. Third thing has to be from the government side, where you can come up with the curriculum and this thing, and teach them in our schools and colleges. However, fourth and most important factor is we are talking about social this thing, because everybody creates a problem when they get a
social interaction.
So every social problem has to be solved socially.
Yes.
Right. So we believe we want to create a buddy program called Cyber Buddy, whereas the students itself given a knowledge like how to resolve this problem. Students might not go to the teachers or parents to tell something.
Hmm.
So they might talk to their friends or saying that, okay, I have this kind of issue, or maybe even we have some undercover students which will help them to identify the issues within the class. And they should solve this problem at a certain level. And up above that, if there is some bigger issue, they can actually take help of the teachers and all. So that entire curriculum we are trying to develop. And this, when we actually come up with this idea, we thought like we can have a cyber smart schools,
right,
where the schools have implemented all these policies.
Correct.
And we can rate them at certain level. And
correct,
you know, schools are like, okay, we have this kind of rating.
Of course,
definitely like to show that to the parents. And I think that's will actually, this four-way approach will actually help to solve this kind of issue.
Thank you so much. Others want to add, so I'm going to raise them, okay. And then do what?
Throw it away. Most of your useless things from your phones, like social medias, and just keep one which is necessary, please.
Okay.
And I would request responsible netizen to please carry on this movement that cyber
cyber hygiene.
Definitely.
Okay. Yeah. Under the rubric of cyber hygiene. Thank you. Questions? Yeah. Yeah, please ask, Arundhati. Yeah. Take the mic, please.
I want to actually add to what Kanan sir said, that at the age, at the starting level, children tend to absorb more. So when we are introducing computer education at a very lower level at first standard, why don't we start a campaign where the children are taught at that level about cyber crimes? Why do we, and if you are making a curriculum, it is stupidity not including it in the system. So if you want to stress that why we don't need to actually force the child, make them do it or not like that, and stress them, instead don't take exams, but at least inculcate that habit of cybercrime in their heads at a lower level, where they know what they can and what they should not do.
Should I add something?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Tushar, so yeah, we have been to schools right from Bandra to somewhere in Ghodbandar, and we generally have a curriculum for 5th, 6th, 7th standard and above. And what we have seen, the things are not same everywhere.
Right.
So definitely, like we heard a question like we are teached paint and not a coral draw. However, for some, paint is also fantastic. Like they can see like, okay, I can work on a paint. Mm. And some people might get a coral draw at the age of 6 or 7. Okay, so when it comes to setting up a curriculum, they have to make sure, or it's on a basic level, okay, to start with. When it comes to a first and second standard, what I have found out, like when we talk to them about at fifth standard, they don't know even some of the terms. And we don't want them to know as well. We don't want them to teach like, okay, go. If you go to a Facebook, you will find some person and don't like it. So they will definitely be very curious about this thing. So at one level, it will be very difficult to stage a complete guidelines for standard-wise saying that, okay, they should learn this. But however, definitely government should come up with something like that and figure out like how they can actually put this information. Having content on a video or something will help, and parent can actually figure out like at what level they should be giving this content to them.